But we start with some startling statistics. 6 million Americans are currently living with Alzheimer's, and that includes 49,000 people over the age of 65 right here in Nevada.
And you have to realize that each and every patient needs at least one caregiver. Together, those caregivers provide close to 80 million hours of unpaid care. That adds up to a lot of people impacted by Alzheimer's. And the fact is, most of us will someday face memory issues, either ourselves or through a loved one.
Oh, we ain't got a barrel of money.
It's a Tuesday morning at Summit Estates, and in the memory care unit, that means music.
Singing our song, side by side.
This is just one of the activities caregivers here orchestrate for their residents.
It just breaks up their day. It breaks up monotony, and they just love it. Outside coming in, they love it.
Side by side, through all kinds of weather.
It's a time that they can go back, and songs trigger certain memories, and then they forget where they're at. They forget that they're here.
And Colin Ross, yes, our Colin Ross, is tuned in to how this helps. That's why he plays for a lot of memory care facilities around town. In fact, he's been doing this for 20 years.
I try and analyze the age group, and I'm trying to do music from when they were teenagers and early 20s, because that's the music that really sticks with them. And if I pick the right music, they can remember music when they can not remember hardly anything else. And I try and really enunciate so that they can tell what I'm doing.
When it goes to St. Louis, Chaplin, Missouri, Oklahoma City, look.
And they start tapping, and they listen, and they go, oh, yeah. And that one song that was coming on, the one resident looked at me, she goes, I know what song this is about, because it was her song, her name.
Good night, I mean, good night, I'll see.
I almost never say, oh, do you remember this? Or any of those kind of questions. I just say, I think you remember this. Or here's one that we can all do together. I change the key phrases so that they aren't challenged by the phrases that I say and that they're more reinforced by them.
It takes a special person to be a caregiver.
I love their stories. I love getting to know them. And I don't care how many times they tell me the same time where they were living at Pennsylvania Hershey's and they went by this, I'll hear it over and over again. I just love being with them.
When you deal with Alzheimer's every day, you learn to see it from a patient's point of view.
They're aware that their mind's not working. They're aware of their memory loss. They're aware, and it scares them more than anything else. And they just need us to understand and be patient and kind and loving to them. And don't judge them, and don't correct them, and don't remind them. You just go into their world and play, and they feel normal.
Alzheimer's impacts a lot more people than patients, whether in a residence like this or at home.
It's not just affecting people 65 and older, it's affecting anyone. And a lot of times it is families living, you know, spouses or maybe adult children taking care of their parents at the early stages of the disease. And, you know, there are actually people my age who might be caring for maybe a parent who has early onset Alzheimer's, or even a grandparent who is living with it.
Alzheimer's patients all need caregivers, and you know what? Caregivers all need support.
The majority of our services, a lot of people don't know, are actually designed to support caregivers. So those support groups, they're so that they can interact with people who are going through similar situations or have been through something that they're going through right now. They are the ones, you know, that need the education, need the information on how to best find resources and next steps for their loved one.
The Alzheimer's Association offers that support in the form of education, information, and respite care.
Families can come, they can give us a call, and they can provide resources to help step in if the primary caregiver needs to have their own doctor's appointments or run errands or things like that.
Shelley wasn't always this accepting, but she has grown with the job.
At first, it was hard, but then I remember why I'm doing this. You start thinking, I'm afraid, like, what if this is me? But then I thought, well, then let me give back to them, and hopefully I will have that experience back to me. You pay it forward.
I'm not moving something up with me.
There are a lot of ways to help patients and caregivers, from volunteering to raising money at events like the upcoming Alzheimer's Walk, which is next Saturday, October 8th at 9:30 in the morning, and it's at the Sparks Marina. Aging and Awesome will be there, and you're invited to come and join our team.
So we've set up a link for you on our website to the Alzheimer's Association for you to join our team at the Walk to End Alzheimer's. Head to agingandawesome.com.